Hey guys, what's up? Today we are going to draw a Celtic Trinity knot inside Adobe Illustrator. I'm Kent, and this is DiaGraphics. So the first thing we want to do is go to View, then go to Show Grid, then go to View again, and Snap to Grid. Then go to Window, and find your Transform window. Mine is already open down in the corner. Now go to this drop-down menu, and uncheck Align New Objects to Pixel Grid. This will make our drawing more precise. Now go to your ellipse tool and draw an ellipse that fills out one square. Then select the fill and remove it. Now choose the rectangle tool. Now go to the middle of the circle and go one line up and draw a rectangle like this. Now select both shapes. Select the shape builder tool and while holding down the Alt key to get this minus icon, click the stroke of the circle inside the rectangle to delete it. Now choose the rectangle and delete that one too. This will leave us with almost a half circle. So now we can disable Snap to Grid. So go to View again, go to Snap to Grid, then go to View again and Hide Grid. We don't need this feature anymore. So select the shape, go to Edit, go to Copy, then go to Edit again and paste in front. This will create a copy of the shape on top of the original. So while having the copy selected, choose the Reflect tool and while holding down the Alt key, click on the left side of the shape, and inside this pop-up, click Preview. Now type in 30 degrees and click Copy. Now, while still having the new shape selected, hold down the Alt key again and click at the anchor point on top of the new shape. This time, type in 90 degrees. Click Copy. Now select all the shapes and choose the width you want for your stroke. And as you can see, the strokes are not closed. And we are not going to. We want to fix these corners in another way. So now go to the stroke menu and click projecting cap. This almost fixes it. But if I zoom in on the corner, you can see these small misalignments right here. Now let's zoom out again. So when you're happy with the stroke width, we want to create the outline. So we need to convert this stroke to a shape. So now go to object, go to path, and go to outline stroke. Now the strokes are converted to shapes. So while having all the shapes selected, zoom in tight on one of the corners. Then go to the Shape Builder tool, and while holding down the Alt button to subtract, delete these four small misalignments. Now do the same thing with the other corners. Now all the misalignments are deleted, and it's time to add the outline. So now select the color you want for the fill. I will choose this light blue. And select the stroke, and select the color for the stroke. Now select the width that you want for your stroke. Don't worry about the color, you can always change it. So when you're happy with the width of your fill and outline, we want to merge the shapes. So once again, select your entire shape, go to the Shape Builder tool, and combine these three shapes by clicking and dragging. Do this in all corners. So from here, we want the right side of this shape to overlap the other shape. So go to the right side of the shape and click and drag. Go to the right side, click and drag. Go to the right side and click and drag. This is the basic shape and now we want the circle. And the circle is a little bit tricky to align to the exact center, so keep watching. It is not possible to use the align panel to align the circle to the middle, because as you see, this is the middle of the shape, but there's a longer distance from the middle of this triangle to the top than to the bottom. So what we want to do instead is choose the line tool and draw a line from this anchor point and all the way down to this anchor point right here. And make sure it snaps. Now draw another one from this anchor point and from this anchor point to this anchor point. Now zoom in very tight on the middle. Go to the selection tool and select all the shapes. This will give you the exact center. Now go to the ellipse tool and find where it says intersect. This is the exact middle. From here, hold down the Alt key and the Shift key and draw a circle. The size isn't important right now. Now zoom out and select the guidelines we just drew and delete them. Now select the circle and while holding down the Alt key and the Shift key, drag out the circle and watch if all the three tips of the shape can touch the circle. This way you can check if the circle is in the exact center. If not, you made a mistake and you have to draw the circle again, using the previous steps. When the centering is confirmed, you can shrink down your circle so it goes through around half of this shape. There is no rules for the size of this circle. This is just what I like. Now make the width of this stroke the same as the width of your Trinity knot. So go to the width drop down and choose the same width. Now if you want to adjust the size of your circle, just hold down the Alt and the Shift key and adjust it as you like. When you are happy with the size of the circle and while having the circle selected, go to Object, go to Path and go to Outline Stroke. Now select the same color as your Trinity knot and select the stroke and select the stroke color. Also adjust the width to be the same. Now select all the shapes, go to the Shape Builder tool and this time you want the left side to overlap. So click and drag the left side.